So now let's talk about the surround video on the G3. We've started shipping this product this month. Some of you may have already received them if you placed your orders. If you haven't, I would recommend getting your orders in. So this, I hope everyone is familiar with this by now. We've done a lot of marketing around it. I'll just quickly go over, do a brief overview. So this is our third generation surround video Omni. This has a complete remote setup configuration. So in other words, each of the gimbals is configurable without touching it. You can pan, you can tilt, you can focus and zoom. Each gimbal has a focus zoom motorized lens on it. And we have these presets. So if you want to do a 180, 270, 360 configuration, then we have buttons for those presets. And that's actually what I'm going to talk about in just a minute, is how those presets work. So I would encourage everyone to check out the videos we've done that kind of show the versatility and how these are installed. They're on our website. They're on our social media platforms. One of them was from an installation that we did with an installer up in the Fresno area. And you'll see in the video, if you take a look at it, he's only on a ladder for about 4.5 minutes. And that was the first time he'd ever seen one of these cameras. So the idea with this camera is, you know, you just go hang it up in the ceiling, and then you walk away and you go to your PC and you configure everything. And the videos outline that very well, so I would encourage everyone to go take a look. So for that installation, we actually used the 270-degree configuration, one of the presets. And I wanted to talk a little bit about how those presets work. So you'll notice when you open the user interface, it looks a little different than other surround video products that we have. So there's a tab on the top left called presets, and we have these preset configurations. And the first one is just a home configuration, and that's a good one to use when you want to just get all of the gimbals back to some known location. So maybe you're in there and you've been configuring them individually and you kind of get a little bit lost on where you're at, or maybe you want to start over. You could always just hit the home button. And that'll take the gimbals back to the position that's shown there on the right, where it's 1, 4, 3, 2, and I'll explain the numbering in a second. And each Omni camera has a sensor that the number 2 gimbal will interact with, and that's the home position. That also aligns with the front location, which is going to be on your base plate. So if you go back to this first slide here, you can see on the bottom right hand that there's a base plate that the camera hangs from. On that base plate, there's going to be an arrow that says front. And the front indicates the front of your panoramic field of view. So if you know that you want to use a panoramic field of view, or you want to use one of the presets for 180 or 270, then the front is going to be the center of that field of view. And that'll hopefully make sense, a little more sense in a second when I get to the next slides. But the reason we have this home position is so that we can calibrate where we're at. That's how we know where each gimbal is, by going to the home position, and then from there we go off to our presets. So before every preset, we're going to go to this home position. So don't be confused when it goes to this home position that this is the 180 preset. It's not. This is the home position. The 180 preset looks very different, as I'll show you in a second. So the next button you're going to see is the 360-degree preset. Now, when you hit the 360-degree preset, or when you hit any preset, as I said, the first thing that happens is the gimbals are going to go home. So if you have the gimbals off in the field somewhere, if you've been playing with the camera, or just out of the box, it's not going to be in the home position. It's going to be actually configured kind of like a 360. So the first thing that's going to happen when you hit the 360 is it's going to go to the home position. So don't be confused about when it goes to the home position, because it will go to the home position and it will stop for a second, it'll calibrate, and then it'll go back out to the 360. So don't think that when you hit 360 that, oh no, it's going to a 180. It's not. It's just going to its home position, and then it'll go off to its preset. And in this case, with the 360, the front position doesn't really matter, because you're getting 360 degrees of coverage. So you don't really need to worry about that front arrow for this one. When you need to worry about it is for the other presets, which is the 270 and the 180. So first let me say that the presets for 180 is a three-sensor 180-degree field of view with one in the back looking down. Those that are familiar with our recommended configuration for a 270 on our previous generation Omnis know that what we recommend is creating a 270-degree field of view with the three sensors and then having one looking down for full coverage on the corner of a building. So we do a similar thing here with the 180. So the 270 is, as with the Omni 2 and Omni 1, a three-sensor 270 with one looking down. And we do the same thing for the 180. It's a three-sensor 180 with one looking down. So the first thing that's going to happen when you hit that 270 or 180 preset, again, the gimbals are going to go to that home position. And then they will go off to their preset. And now you can see why the front position is important and why the number 2 gimbal is the one that goes to the home sensor. Because when you go to a 270 or 180, the 2 is going to want to be the center of your field of view. That's the center of your panoramic image. And then the reason that the 1 is somewhat out of sequence in the home position is because now when you hit the 270 or 180 preset, the 1 can go all the way around to the other side. And now you have your panoramic field of view as you're used to with other surround video panoramic cameras that we have. So I hope that that makes sense, and I hope that clears up any confusion that there might be about the presets. I've had a couple people say, well, you know, when I hit the 180 preset, it looks like it's going to a 180, but then it goes to 270. And that's really not what's happening. What's happening is it's going to its home position, which you might think looks like a 180, but then it's going to go and do its preset. The other thing I would say is you know, the whole preset process takes approximately 4 minutes from start to finish. So what's going to happen is, you know, they're going to go to the home position, then they're going to go to their preset position, okay? And that's just the panning portion of it. Then they're going to tilt, right? There is a predefined tilt angle that each gimbal is going to go to, and then it's going to go through a focusing algorithm to focus each lens. Okay, so you're going to hear, even after the gimbals get to the 180 or 270 position, you're going to hear the motor still moving. Even after they tilt, you're going to hear the motor still moving because there's going to be a process for focusing and zooming each lens, because each lens, you can imagine, has to zoom to the correct position to get the field of view necessary for either a 270 or a 180. So there'll be a lot of activity going on throughout the whole preset process. You'll know when it's finished, but don't be confused about the noise from the motors after they've already gotten to their position, because there's still some work to do even after you do the panning. Okay. Now, if you have mounted your camera and you did not pay attention to the front arrow and you've gone to your preset 270 or 180 and you think, oh my gosh, I'm not looking in the right direction. Well, we have some options to adjust that. You know, you can always go to the individual focus PTZ tab, and you can individually move each gimbal to fix any issues that you have with your presets if you want to. But we also have an option. You can see I've circled it there in the focus and pan tab. There's a drop-down menu, and one of the options is 1 through 4. So if you want to move one of the gimbals, you could select 1, 2, 3, or 4, and then you could pan those individually if you want to tweak one of them. But if you did want to tweak the entire preset, you just select 1 through 4, and now you can pan step by step the entire preset. So if you'd screwed up the front position, as I said, and you want to move it over a little bit, that's the best option, and the quickest way to do that would be to select that, and then you'll move the entire preset step by step. There's also an option in the tilt and zoom area for moving or tilting your preset. And in this case, the option for selecting multiple is 1, 2, and 3. And as you can imagine, if you have your preset 180 or 270 using the three sensors, you're going to want to only tilt the panoramic image. So you would select 1, 2, and 3, and now I can tilt my entire panoramic image either up or down. And then if I wanted to tilt the number 4, the one in the back looking down, I would just select number 4 as an individual gimbal and tilt it that way. And in fact, you know, we did this when we were doing an installation last month. We had installed one of these, and it was up higher than what the presets were designed for. You know, the recommended height for these is around 10 to 15 feet. This was up higher on a roof, and the tilt angle that is predefined in the preset was a little high. So all we had to do was select this option and then just step it down till we found the position that we liked. And then we went to number 4 and actually tilted that one as well individually. So that's how you would operate the presets. And I hope that makes sense to everyone. However, I think most people will probably configure this camera using the individual tabs. For most installations that are not going to require a preset, you're going to install this in a situation, maybe an indoor situation, where you want to look at various things and configure it to the unique installation that you have. And you're going to probably want to use just the individual focus and PTZ tab, where you can go through and select each gimbal individually and then walk that around and configure it exactly how you want it. So you can zoom to a different angle, you can pan or tilt to whatever angle that you like. If you do this and you sort of get things screwed up and you're not liking what you're doing, remember, you can always just go back to the presets, hit the home button, and kind of start over. Or go back to the preset, hit the 360 button, and start from there, if that's what you want to do. That might make things a little easier for you. I would recommend that everybody go look at the video that we created, which is on our website. It's also on Facebook and LinkedIn and YouTube. It goes through an installation that we did here in our own building, and it shows how versatile and how we individually go through and configure each gimbal for the unique installation that we had. We actually installed one down in our manufacturing room, where we have, it's kind of like an L-shaped room, and obviously a preset wouldn't work in that situation, so we go through and we configure each gimbal to look at exactly what we want to look at. And it's a really informative video, and it'll explain the product very well. So I would encourage everyone to go take